All right, so now the Ontario government and the federal government are in discussions on a paid sick leave plan for the province of Ontario. And while that happens, the infections in workplaces continue. Let's discuss what is happening in the province of Ontario with three members of parliament from that province. Jennifer O'Connell is the Liberal MP for Pickering-Uxbridge and the parliamentary secretary to the Minister of Health. Eric Duncan is the Conservative MP for Stormont, Dundas, South Glengarry and the question period coordinator for the official opposition. And Lindsay Matheson is the NDP MP for London Fanshawe and her party's deputy whip. Good to see you all. Jennifer O'Connell, let me start with you. The military stepped in to help in Ontario. Other provinces are stepping up to help Ontario. The hospital system and the dedicated workers on the front lines there, they're being overwhelmed, and there's still no paid sick leave plan in the province. How do you explain why Ontario is being so hard hit by the third wave?
Well, I mean, first let me just start and thank those healthcare workers. In particular in Ontario, we're seeing the stress and the strain they're under. And so to see health support coming from Newfoundland today was really a point of pride for me. My family is actually from Newfoundland, so it was really nice to see that help arriving. But when it comes to infection rates, we know that the vast majority are in our communities. So it's really important that we don't lose all of the work that we've done throughout this pandemic to fight this virus, and that we continue to take those strong public health measures to keep our communities safe.
But has it been a failing of some of those measures, do you think, that's put Ontario where it is? Or the failure to take stronger measures?
Well, I mean, I think what we've been encouraging at the federal level is to listen to science and evidence. And there was modeling back in February talking about what was needed in these measures. And so I think now, as a federal government, as federal representatives, we're encouraging Ontario to take the evidence-based approach and to put in place measures that are going to make a real impact in these communities.
Mr. Duncan, most other provinces are doing better than Ontario at controlling the spread of the third wave. And I guess I'm looking for your thoughts. Why are things so bad in the province of Ontario?
Well, Peter, they're bad across the country. There are other provinces that are in third waves and having significant strains in their healthcare system. Ontario is certainly one of them, without a doubt. To answer your question about why we're in the situation, it's because the federal government has not got enough vaccines to the provinces to be distributed and get shots in arms. We look at jurisdictions. We're watching with envy. Peter, I watched this weekend, the Las Vegas Strip is coming back to life. We're seeing domestic and international air travel in the U.S. increasing. And meanwhile, we're in lockdowns, we're in restrictions. The United Kingdom, Israel, countries that have had good vaccine rollouts have been reopening. Those that haven't procured them, like our federal government did not do, that's why we're in this third wave right now, Peter.
Okay, Lindsay.
And not just Ontario. Many provinces are in it.
Right,
I'm looking at Nova Scotia, smaller numbers, but they're
They're having some problems as well. Lindsay Matheson, what's your view on what's been happening in Ontario and the fact that it's been so hard hit by a third wave?
Thanks, Peter. It is a combination of vaccine rollout. And let's be honest, New Democrats have been calling for a long time for additional supports to go to the province of Ontario, calling for the Prime Minister to bring forward the Emergencies Act, making sure that all hands are on deck, bringing in the military. But one of the key things, of course, is that we're pushing for paid sick leave and to strengthen the federal sick leave program. Which is something that Doug Ford has now sort of said that he wants to glum onto, and yet it's not sufficient to just double it. So many experts, healthcare experts in the field have said that's not enough.
Let's talk about that. Jennifer O'Connell, the Ontario government's been promising improved sick leave for workers who don't have paid days now. The Ontario proposal being put forward today would double weekly sick leave payments in Ontario to $1,000, but have those extra payments administered through the existing federal pandemic sickness benefit program. Prime Minister rejected that idea today, saying, look, what the Ford government needs to do is mandate paid sick leave for employees at all provincially regulated companies. So what's the argument for Ontario having to set up its own plan when there's a federal plan in place already?
Well, I think, first of all, they do different things. From day one, we also supported paid sick days. So our commitment is there. But we can only mandate in federally regulated jurisdictions or provide a system like we have now, which provides based on, in this case, an application basis when you need them. And that helps a lot of Canadians, in particular self-employed Canadians, et cetera. But I think the simplest explanation is Ontario had 3 paid sick days and they were cut in 2018, simply reinstating those, because I think the gap that many health experts are looking for is a system where employees, for example, could take a day off to go get a vaccine, to go get tested, if they're not feeling well, to not go to work. And like that is, I think, the system that experts are calling for in Ontario, and that is a system that existed. So simply reinstating it would go a long way.
Yeah,
and
to be clear, portion. Yeah, to be clear, the federal plan is a retroactive plan. So if you're sick, you apply for the benefits and you get them in often in some cases in 3 or 4 or 5 days, but it can be complicated. And if you do have to go get tested or take a couple of days off, you've lost that money out of that week's paycheck and you have to wait for it to come back. So Mr. Duncan, Doug Ford's repeatedly criticized the federal sick leave program and now he wants to piggyback on it. He stated he doesn't want to pass on any more cost to business in the province. So how much of this reluctance to mandate paid sick leave in Ontario in a pandemic is about not wanting to create permanent paid sick days after the pandemic?
Well, I'm not privy to the conversations that the Ontario and federal government have been having, but I do think that, you know, I'm sure Jennifer and Lindsay are both in the same situation. Our office has been inundated, my constituency office, with problems with EI and with CERB. So I think these conversations of how easy we can get these benefits set up and how easily we can get them distributed to people using existing systems, I think is a natural question to ask. And again, the line the government uses all the time, every step of the way, they say that they've been there with provinces and territories. We have a province that's asking for help in the administration of this, and I think it warrants a conversation to see, is there a way to make this work? If there's a way to get this out and get the money out, to your point, as quickly as possible. There's certainly been a lot of kinks in the program in issues with it at the federal level in terms of getting people paid, but I think at the end of the day, people just want a simplistic thing that's not going to be overly bureaucratic.
Yeah, well,
create something from scratch in a matter of days.
That's probably the key, and Lindsay Matheson, For people watching, some of this is going to sound like passing the buck and playing politics between federal and provincial governments over people's lives here. What do you believe has to happen?
I think that when you start to talk about all these programs, there's a political will involved, and it was designed in a flawed format. There has definitely been barriers to access in terms of that recovery benefit, and you're absolutely right when you point out that if people want to take 1 or 2 days, they have to take the entire allotment. They don't get their money right away. These are key things that stand in the way, and people are hurting right now. And so ultimately, when we wanted to put forward that Emergencies Act, it was to ensure that people were put first in this pandemic, and that you figure out the details after, but you put people first and you ensure that they have the services and the help that they need.
Is there a way to get the money at the door quickly now and set up? I mean, that seems to be what Ontario is after. Get the money at the door quickly in the existing program. And the federal government's response to some degree, Jennifer O'Connell, has been, look, our IT systems don't work that way, and we really don't want to make a singular type of payment to one province and not to other provinces. Are those valid reasons for not wanting the Ontario model?
I don't think it's an IT system. It's as you described. We have, whether it was through CERB or EI, our processing is through these types of programs. And as you pointed out, it's retroactive. This, if you want mandated legislative sick days, which federally regulated sectors have, because we can make those legal changes. But in terms of processing, it actually takes 3 days once it's applied for. I think the difference, the nuance that everybody is talking about, is the difference from when you get a paycheck and if you take a day off for you know, sick leave, and your pay isn't affected because it versus a government-run program. And so if you want that uninterrupted day off, That is something that has to come through the labor legislation at the Ontario government, which existed. And as I said, at the federal level, we implemented for federally regulated
Mr. Duncan, is the easiest thing to do here just to have the Ontario government introduce a law that says there's going to be paid sick leave days for people who don't have them now?
I think there's a challenge when it comes to businesses, and there's been a lot of strain, and we don't need to say how much strain or reiterate again how much businesses have been under with the lockdowns and the restrictions, and particularly now in the third wave. I think what the province is trying to do, and what many provinces are trying to do, is to help businesses out, help people out as well, and balance all that out. Look, I say at the end of the day, and Peter, I take your point, people are interested in a solution at the end of the day, and I do think it is, you know, there is an IT factor, and there's a deliverability aspect to this as well. I certainly think that we need to make sure that the conversations are happening between, it's just not a hard no, you're on your own. I think we have to look at that, but I think there's also a pressure as well. We don't want this to be a final straw for any business anywhere. There's a balance. We need to help help people. The province has alluded to that. But how can we quickly and easily get that out the door is what they're asking for.
Lindsay Matheson, let me get a final word from you here on how quickly this can happen and should happen.
Again, this is about political will, and we need to put the politics aside. The federal government has a responsibility. The provincial government has a responsibility. And I would actually argue that in terms of businesses, yes, there is responsibility there. But let's think about the long-term impacts they have of having to shut down entirely again because of the spread of COVID and yet a fourth wave. And so let's look at the long-term consequences of not doing anything and not taking the responsibility that the governments need to.
All right. Lots to consider in your comments tonight. Thank you all for your time. Take care, everyone. We'll talk again.
Thank you so much.